Yes, wonderful. Oh, that's live. Yes, we're live. Yes, hello to all of you watching the live stream, and thank you all for coming out. I've made a new friend here. I haven't named it yet. The old one's called Sasha. But this one, we haven't figured out yet. Most Native Americans, they, 100 years ago, they wait 5 years to name their children, so hopefully it won't take quite that long. It took me 5 hours to find and select this instrument. What a joy. I've done it 3 times, been down to the factory, and it's quite a procedure, running back and forth, literally running to keep the sound of the previous instrument in your ear, and comparing sounds and what you're looking for, the different qualities. And this one had everything that I wanted, and I do have to thank so many people for making this possible. I won't remember them all, so I'll just thank everyone who was involved in selecting this, particularly Brendan Murphy from Steinerts, who was really, gave good counsel in terms of finding the right instrument, so I appreciate that. We're going to start with a favorite work of mine. I had intended to do an all-Cuban program tonight, as was shown in the arts calendar, but I decided that, you know, Cuban music is such a strong style that I wanted to select something that would also highlight the innate qualities of this instrument. I thought that Bach and Beethoven would be a good way to do that. So I decided a couple weeks ago to add this to the program to really show the poetic qualities of the instrument. So that's why I call it the poetic piano. And we're so grateful also to the Morell family for the donation of the previous instrument, which has its wonderful, brilliant qualities, and it will be a nice partner to this instrument. And you'll have to come next year when we do the 2-piano clavier fest, so you'll get to hear them both side by side. So let's start with some Bach.
Thank you.
let's frame this moment, since this is a unique occasion when someone, you know, gets to hear a piano for the first time. What do you hear in the instrument? Smoothness, yeah. What else?
Versatility.
Say it. It sparkles, okay.
Versatility.
Okay. Clarity, huh?
Versatility.
Part of the playing, too. Graceful, yes. Yes. I couldn't have predicted how perfect the instrument was for the room. I can play about as soft as you can imagine, and it's still so clear. I think you heard that. It's very exciting to have an instrument with that depth of nuance and skill. Beethoven's Opus 109, one of his last sonatas, according to him, written as if in one breath, along with the two that come after, which of course end the entire 32 sonata cycle, is a very, very particularly poetic work, one that looks forward to a lot of the freedom that the Romantic composers took, and you'll hear that in this first movement particularly, and so much poetry in this music. He, of course, tips his hat to Bach in the final movement with the Saraband and Variations, a la Goldberg, of course, and he returns to the theme at the very, very end after a series of progressively challenging and beautiful variations. Beethoven, of course, was completely deaf at this point. It's extraordinary to think, not so much that he could compose, because, you know, he could hear for the first part of his life when his training was already, you know, established. So he could hear the tones, but the will to go on is what I find so extraordinary, you know. I think of people who paint with their teeth, you know, because they have no arms. Or I saw a documentary once on a woman who played the organ, and it seemed all very nice. The camera had mostly her bust from her neck up, and very, very beautiful woman, blonde, and she was being interviewed, and then halfway through, the camera pulls away, and you see that she has no arms. And she leans back in the chair she's sitting in, puts her feet up on a little Hammond organ or something, and she begins to play the organ with her feet, no joke. I've never seen it. I mean, maybe some of you might remember or know who that is. But Beethoven, going on to write some of the most memorable music in history after losing his hearing, and not to mention, of course, probably the ongoing pain he suffered from the tinnitus he had as well. So, very extraordinary. I think this piece will really show off the quality of the instrument in another way. So, let's continue then. Thank you.
Thank you.